going into the evening, how confident were you that you would win Driver of the Year?
I was confident I would win. I just was nervous. You know, it's, you never know with voting, and you know, I look, it was such a terrific year, obviously, and you know, I was just happy to be nominated. It's the first time I've ever been nominated, so it was a really exciting feeling for me, for sure.
And what was your reaction when you heard your name announced as winner of Driver of the Year?
I was just like overcome with joy. Like you know, anyone that was watching probably heard the roar at our house there, and you know, everyone was happy and emotional, and you know, it was just a really special feeling I'll never forget.
And what does it mean to you to win an O'Brien Award?
It means everything. I mean, that's, to me, like I've said in interviews before, like quietly it's always been a goal, but I haven't really been close enough to even for me to even think about saying it out loud. So to just, you know, all year I was thinking about it, and people would say it to me, and I would think about it, and like when I'd have a good night, I would say, you know, if I can keep this going, maybe I can get nominated, or maybe, and then I kept, you know, winning, and the big races were coming in, and it just started to get more real as the year went on, and it's really amazing, and I'm really proud of it.
And what is the significance for you of winning this award the first year that it was named after Keith Waples?
Oh, it means everything. Keith Waples is a legend in this business, and I've never come across anyone that didn't have the fondest memories of Keith and racing against him, and his overall, like, just his demeanor, his talent. He personified a horse driver. Everyone that's ever talked to him says he was, you know, probably the greatest driver of all time. Or so to have that name tied into you, being at the top of your sport, it's really special. So thanks to the Waples family, and you know, happy to be here.
And what achievement are you most proud of from your 2021 season, and why?
Probably just the consistency. Like all year, like I've always been a big time streaky driver. Like I'd get really hot, but I would get really cold too, you know. And like last year, I just kept saying, well, I've got the cold streak's coming. And it was just, I'd have a bad night and I'd say, okay, here it comes. And then the next night I'd win four. So it was just consistency and being able to, you know, night in, night out, perform at a high level. That's what I'm most proud of.
And you've had so many highlights, so let's talk about some of your 322 wins. What was your most unexpected win?
I don't know about unexpected, but I would say probably Lindy the Great, because Maple Leaf Trot, just because I wasn't expecting to get the drive. The year prior, no one came up, so I had people call and ask, or they called and asked to drive Lindy, and you know, so it was more real last year, and then this year everyone was coming up, and I didn't really have a top trotter, and when they asked, or when they didn't even really ask, they came out on the sheet, and I saw that I was down on him. I was pretty excited, and then you know, I knew he was racing really well and had a shot, but you know, I needed a lot to go right, and everything went perfect that night. So probably Lindy the Great, just because, like I said, it wasn't expected to drive him.
And what was your most tactical win?
Maybe one of Prohibition's gold, or Prohibition Legal's gold wins. Just not so much tactical, as you know, I knew she hadn't had the best couple weeks going into the race, and I was heavy favorite or favorite, and knew I couldn't be overly aggressive, and I had to try and find a way to win, but not overdo it to the horse and hurt her going forward. So the trip worked out great, and obviously the horse was unbelievable. So I don't know if it was tactical as much as the horse was just a machine that night.
What was your easiest win?
Probably every start after that when Prohibition Legal raced. She was such a good horse, and do anything first up on the front, third over, like it didn't matter. She's just, every time she went behind the gate, she's just a little bit better, a step above her competition, and it made my job just incredibly easy, and such a Cadillac to drive, like doesn't ever do a thing wrong, quiet, like almost too quiet. So yeah, I was really fortunate to have a lot of really great horses this year, and you know, to get a chance to drive horses like that, or a Dare Castle, or any of those big stake horses, I mean, when they get in where they should win, it's like you just sit there.
What's the most fun you had at the track in 2021?
I would say probably when I was in the States riding around with my brother Mark. I don't get to see him very often. You know, we never really had an opportunity. Like, he's a few years older, so he wasn't, like, he was, him and Anthony moved out when I was pretty young. And then when I moved to Ontario, he was so busy, and I was busy at the barn, and we didn't really hang out a whole lot. And then this summer when I went down, I lived with him, and we did everything together. We golfed, we had some sociable cocktails together, and traveled together to race, and you know, that was a lot of fun for me, and it's great to see him and Aaliyah and Kiki. So I'd say that was probably the most fun I had.
What are you looking forward to in 2022?
Just trying to keep the ball rolling. I mean, I'm off to a great start, so you know, obviously I'm not going to set expectations like last year, and I don't expect to repeat that or anything close to that. So I'm just hoping to be consistent again, and you know, if I get on a bad spell, just try and ride it out and not have it last too long, and if I get on a hot spell, try and keep it lasting. So that's probably what I'm looking forward to most. And you know, winning races, that's the best feeling in the world. And if I can, every night you win one or two or whatever, it's a really fun feeling.
And there are a number of drivers in the Mohawk Driving Colony that are now O'Brien Award winners. There are a number of up-and-coming drivers that are also working their way up that ladder. Who impresses you the most?
Wow, tough question. It's like I've said over and over again, this is such a deep colony. Like, whoever's getting the good horses are hot at the right time. Like, you're seeing what Doug's doing right now. He's on fire and just driving out of this world. So same with Louie, Bob, you know, Sylvan, Jody, JD, everyone. Like, Travis Cullen's terrific. Austin Sorey's jumped on the scene doing well. Scott Young, if he gets some, you know, nice horses to drive, he's doing well. So I like to say anyone impresses me, I would probably go with a young guy like Austin. I mean, he's 21, I think, or he might not even be 21. Like, maybe he's 22. I don't know how old he is. He's young. And I hadn't even driven a horse till I was 23. So to be competing here, and he's just got such a good attitude, you know, he's just really excited to be doing well. And if he's not doing well, he's not kicking buckets or dragging his lip around. You know, he's trying to work harder and get better. And there's a lot of young guys around right now that are, you know, really impressive. So I would say him, you know, for sure. The rest of them, like Trevor and those guys, like, they're just so good. Like, and they can win any given night, and they're all nipping at your heels every night to get across that line first. So, I wouldn't be shocked whoever won the O'Brien Award this year. Like, I got the utmost respect for all of them, and would be, you know, happy to cheer them on if they had a terrific season.
You've spoken about the support of your family at length, including your brothers sharing advice early in your career. What advice would you give someone just starting out or interested in pursuing a driving career?
I try and give advice, like, when I see younger guys come along, just because I've had so much help to get me where I got to. The biggest thing is just believe in yourself. Be confident as much as you can. I know it's hard when you're not doing any good, but basically, if you're not getting great horses to drive, you're only human. You know, you can't make whatever. So my biggest advice would be just believe in yourself, be super confident in yourself, and do the best you can. And like, work hard, show up. That's the biggest thing. Show up every time, every night. Be polite. Like, you gotta have good people skills. So just work hard, show up, be confident, for sure.